Hello guys, welcome everyone to the forexboat.com channel, and today yet another idea. This time we'll be looking at the Canadian versus Japanese yen currency pair. I would like to remind you that all the information in this video is just for educational purpose only and should not be considered as a financial advice. Well, let's get back, quickly recap on our previous ideas, starting with the euro GBP long term. Here we had the entry at approximately 87.90. This idea is still valid. We still expect the price to move quite a bit to the downside. So not much of movement as expected, guys. We are actually going back and forth. And in our previous video, I was talking about potential spike above this high. In fact, it will most likely be the spike if we look at the daily chart. And I don't think we will be closing above this spike. So here, still a valid downtrend trade idea. Now on the another idea we had, you see from this price was a short. Well, in fact, it almost reached the target, although price decided to go up. But as I said, we still expect this long-term downtrend, and at least this target should be hit this week, I would expect. Now next one is Swiss franc Japanese yen. This is the long-term. This idea actually is closed. We had a target which has been reached, but I'm just updating you as to what we expect. So overall, a very strong downtrend here. New Zealand versus Canadian. This is the first idea we had, original one. Still expecting the target to breach. It's moving slowly, although we see some signs of a bullish trend. Now, there was another idea, New Zealand Canadian. This is a lower time frame. After breaking the downtrend trend line, we're expecting this sort of move. So our entry was between 87.20 and 87.00. It's almost, well, it's just above the entry point, so still a valid trade waiting for the target to be reached. The dollar Canadian, guys, is looking quite good. We had an entry early last week, and in fact it's moving quite nicely towards our target, so probably will be quite a fast target on this one. But I think we will be breaking above and moving much higher on the dollar Canadian. This is because I think that the Canadian dollar itself is really struggling because the oil prices, and this tendency will continue. Canadian dollar is just chasing the weakness of the US oil, and this could be for quite a long term. And that's why we have idea on the Canadian versus Japanese yen, because Canadian looking very, very weak, while Japanese looking very, very strong. All in all, this could make Canadian Japanese yen extremely bearish in the long run. Now let's have a look. We have a triangle pattern here formed, and we had a breakout with a daily break and close below the previously established low. Here was no breakout, but then price closed below, suggesting that the trend is bearish, confirming that. Now we had this correction to the upside, and we actually reached the uptrend trend line, which is being rejected. I think this was the top, and Canadian dollar from this point onwards will start moving lower. I can expect also daily spike above this level, but still, if we don't have a close above this high, it will remain bearish. Even if it breaks above, I think there will be consolidation rather than the uptrend, because the key resistance is at this level at 87.43. And considering that the target level 550 pips, so the stop loss to reach risk reward ratio could be at least 250 pips, which is actually higher, it would make it approximately at 79.35, clearly above and still a good risk reward of 2-to-1. But in the shorter term, we need to see the daily close where it's going to be. Now I have applied two FIPs. First is the first correction after this rally to the downside. We have applied FIPs, and here we have several levels. First is 161. Then 261 Fibonacci retracement levels. Also, we have 61.8% FIPS, which was broken, and this also confirms that the trend is getting bearish. Now, in regards to the targets, the nearest I would say could be a double bottom, and then if it's broken, which most likely will be the case, price, I think, will move towards the next target. The next target is the key support, because it's confirmed by two FIBs. You see that there is another Fibonacci retracement applied after breaking and closing below the triangle. Now here, it corresponds to the level of 71.00. And this is the key support with a potential target here of 550 pips. Possibly, if it's broken, price gonna go even lower. And this is actually what I expect. I think it will go even lower, but this will be the key level to watch, after which we might see a very strong pullback, and then only price will continue moving down. Now, on the forward chart, quickly gonna have a look. Massive resistance area has been formed. We can see that here, 200 exponential moving average rejected, then rejected again right there. Now, on the simple moving average, we had the rejection at this price, and here, rejection again. Price produced a spike, but then we failed to close above the spike on the forward chart. None of the candles closed above. We have reached now this area of supply, and this could be the good entry point for the long-term selling opportunities. Although, as I said, there can be spikes. You must be ready for a waiting time of 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks, maybe more, because this is quite a big move for this pair, but it's a quite a strong downtrend that is expected as well. So as you can see, we are clearly at the resistance zone, and from this point onwards could be going down. Now the entry point could be anywhere between 76.60 to, for example, 77.40 pips, the price area, which seems very attractive as a selling opportunity considering it's a 550 pip move. Hope you like this video. We will update you on Wednesday as to what happens to all our previous trade ideas. And if you did like, don't forget to put the like and subscribe to our channel to see more great video analysis for upcoming week. Thank you guys, and talk to you very soon. Take care.